preparing and implementing research instrument. Research instrument is a tool used to gather data on a specific topic of interest. When conducting a research, you need to prepare and implement the appropriate instrument and gather the data you need. When preparing an instrument, you must ensure that it is valid and reliable. In preparing an instrument, you should follow these guidelines. First, do a preliminary research. Second, talk to a person who is knowledgeable in preparing research instruments. Third, familiarize all the guidelines in preparing each type of instrument. Next, choose suitable research instrument which is directly related to your research. Then, estimate the number of your volunteers as soon as possible. After that, prepare the instrument using appropriate format. Get model instrument if necessary. You may visit Google Scholar to get a sample of your intended instrument. Then, edit your instrument. And lastly, review and study your chosen research instrument. Make necessary revision as soon as you receive a feedback. If you want to gather important data, there are different types of instruments you can use depending on the type of research and amount of data you need. These are the following common research instruments that we can use in gathering data. First is survey. A survey contains planned questions which are used to measure attitudes, perceptions, and opinions. There are three types of questions you can use when conducting a survey. First, the recall. The recall type of questions ask for some of the background information about the interviewee, such as year of service, age, and address. Another type of question you can use when conducting a survey is the recognition. Recognition is the type of question, on the other hand, where the interviewer gives an option such as multiple choice, dichotomous, which is answerable by yes or no, and rating scale format. Lastly, the open-ended type of question. It elicits brief explanations or impressions from the respondents. Now, we're done talking about the first type of instrument, which is the survey. So let's go on to another type of instrument, which is the interview. An interview is an instrument that allows the researcher to qualitatively gather data. Responses during an interview are usually open-ended. Here are the following stages you should know once you are conducting an interview. First is the pre-interview stage. Your interviewee should be prepared once you are conducting an interview. You, as an interviewer, should provide an interview guide and you should make sure that your interviewee must be contacted before conducting an interview. The second stage of interview is the warm-up stage. It is the initial part of the interview when questions that will make respondents more at ease are asked. Next is the main interview stage. It is the main questions directly related to the research questions are asked. And the last stage of interview is the closing stage. It is when questions are asked to wind down the interview and respondents are acknowledged and thanked. When conducting an interview, you should follow these guidelines. First, before the interview, you should organize your questions to make the flow of the interview smoother. Next, begin by introducing yourself and the purpose of the interview. Next, the interviewer should promise the interviewee that the gathered data will be kept in private. Then, have a warm-up stage to make the respondents more comfortable. Questions such as how was your day can be asked for this purpose. As an interviewer, you need to consider and adapt the language of your interviewee to avoid misunderstandings. Make the length of the interview reasonable. Otherwise, your respondents might get bored or annoyed. Next, record the interview because you may need to transcribe the gathered data. However, make sure you inform or get the approval of the interviewee. And lastly, always thank the respondents for their time as a sign of gratefulness and appreciation.
I hope you learned a lot about interview. So now, let's go to our next topic, which is the questionnaire. Do you have any idea about questionnaires? According to Merriam-Webster Dictionary, questionnaire refers to a written set of questions that are given to people in order to collect facts or opinion about something. Here are the four parts of a questionnaire. The first part is the personal information section. It includes the name, which is optional, age, date of birth, address, educational background, and the other personal information about the respondent. Note that the only personal information relevant to the research study should be asked. The second part of a questionnaire is the basic questions section, which serves two purposes. First one is to establish that the person you're asking is the right person for the study. The second purpose, which is only applicable to interview, is to establish rapport with the interviewee. Let's go now on the third part of the questionnaire, which is the main question section. Contains questions that are directly related to your research. It is ideal to have multiple questions for each specific research question. The greater the number of questions, the greater the possibility of more conclusive results. The last part of a questionnaire is the open-ended question section, which asks for a brief explanation or response to an open-ended question. If you are planning to do a questionnaire, there are a lot of things that you need to follow. The first thing to do is introduce the questionnaire to your cover letter. The cover letter should explain the purpose and relevance of the study, the length of time in completing the questionnaire, how the data will be processed, your contact details, and the expected date and time in the questionnaire.
Ensure the confidentiality of information. Make sure that the private information will not leak and will be safe with you to avoid misunderstanding with the interviewee and also as a sign of respect. Pilot the questionnaire to ensure that you have not missed any important questions. Use a follow-up reminder. Give respondents sufficient time to answer the questionnaire. It will help your respondents to think and to give you the most suitable answers to the questions. Make all directions and questions clear and unmistakable. Do not use words with double meanings or complex questions. Using appropriate directions and questions will avoid confusion to the interviewee. Ensure that your grammar is correct.
Make the questionnaire as brief as possible without sacrificing content. Arrange and categorize the question logically. Related all questions to your research topic and make sure that responses drawn out are sufficient for your analysis. In relation to the previous guideline, try to make as many questions as possible without being redundant. Avoid embarrassing, unnecessary questions. Explain and illustrate difficult questions. Avoid embarrassing, unnecessary questions. Explain and illustrate difficult questions. State all questions affirmatively. Avoid bias and leading questions.
Observation allows the description of behavior in a naturalistic or laboratory setting. Usually, this instrument is used to cross-validate the result of other instruments. Participant and non-participant observation
A non-participant type of observation allows the researcher to observe the subject without interacting with them. Hence, the subject do not know that they are being observed. This type of observation is usually employed by psychologists when observing animals and children. A participant observation, on the other hand, allows the researcher to interact actively with the subject. In cases, researchers immerse themselves in a group or community for a long period of time.
Structured and unstructured observations.